The other thing, you want to start with the Gregg Brady thing?
Man, did you horrify me early on a Monday morning? God damn. Opie just comes in, he's like, you gotta see this fucking Gregg Brady.
Right, yeah, I remember that. We talked about that one time.
Yeah, we talked about that. We talked about it. We didn't have actual
footage
of it.
There's a, I guess this is sort of a best of clip that has made its way to the internet because someone out there went, holy shit, this has to be on YouTube.
Looks like a little promotional thing, like maybe if you want to.
Oh, you think it's just a promotional clip?
Yeah, I think if you're
going to
sell
tickets through this thing?
Yeah, because it's got Yakov's number on the bottom. And I think if you're thinking about going to see, Barry Williams as the real Gregg Brady.
Yeah.
During what he likes to call the Brady brunch. It's brunch. Startup.
It's called Brady Brunch with Barry Williams, the real Gregg Brady. It's online. Yeah.
Let it rip. The Brady Bunch. And he plays this at the beginning.
This is the part of the show. Right?
This is on the big screen behind him.
Yes.
Of course. That's good. He kills a minute.
Yeah. Wow.
Oh, he kills
and
a minute.
And now they play the Johnny Bravo clip where he puts the jacket on in the original episode.
Like, perfect.
Righteous.
Did I tell you I never miss?
Beautiful.
You're not you anymore.
I don't follow.
You are a superstar. Superstar.
And now
superstar.
It's now it goes,
ladies and gentlemen,
to the stage show.
Mr. Barry Williams.
Oh. Pause.
Oh, God.
And now you see Gregg Brady.
God. He's on
Barry
stage.
Williams. He's on stage, and he's basically has that motion like, huh?
He's like standing there like, all right.
But he's wearing the jacket.
Well, he's not, though. Like, it's a different jacket.
It's supposed to be kind of the same.
Yeah,
but no,
yeah,
he's,
yeah. You'll see in a second, he's claiming this is the exact jacket. But after seeing the original clip, it's so obvious that it's a completely different jacket.
It's not the jacket.
Hit it.
Oh.
It still fits.
Doing?
He's singing. He's so over the top dramatic in singing these songs. Now he's in the Johnny Bravo jacket. He's got the microphone. He's tilting it up like fucking, you know, Vegas guy.
And he's attempting to hit some notes.
And he's trying to hit those notes. Listen to the music.
Well, he's still in the Johnny Bravo jacket, and you're getting a full show.
Oh yeah. This is great. It's a brunch.
I'm trying to get away from the whole Gregg Brady.
Oh, a little comedy. A little comedy, Jimmy.
I'm happy when people just come up and refer to me as plain old Keith Partridge. Which seems to...
See, because Keith Partridge was pretty famous at the
time.
It
wasn't bad, but I'll tell you where he went wrong there. Yeah. Was he did the talking after the punchline, which is like, it's like saying, But folks,
let me tell you.
And almost like he was moving on, but then the laughter was so good he had to stop.
The drummer was already clicking on the hi-hat for the next tune, right. Like in the middle of his punchline. Drummer's just like, shut the fuck up.
You know what I'd love to do?
Yeah.
I would love to, like, not tell him. I would love to buy 500 tickets and give them all to Crips and Bloods. And take that to the show.
Into the music!
You fucking red and blue hats and sneakers being thrown at him.
Oh, wait. We got a few more songs.
Oh, yeah.
Hit this.
Which seems to gotta find my corner.
Damn, it's so over the top.
It just makes me sad.
It is sad. He's in Branson in front of a bunch of old fogies.
Wait till you see the old fogies.
Oh, yeah.
I probably watched this clip 10 times over the weekend. I couldn't get enough
of it.
It's
so uncomfortable. I love it.
Someone is saying this is part of a timeshare scheme.
Jay,
North Carolina. Nice.
The free show you get if you just sit in on our meeting.
Yeah.
It's an Amway meeting.
All right, here we go.
Yeah. Throughout the series, as we began to grow and mature, my attraction to Marcia did not diminish.
Oh, goodness.
And here is Marcia at her grooviest best, and me trying to offer a little advice. to her about how to get out of a date.
Another I need clip. Your advice about something.
Oh, then he plays sure. clips what? From the show.
What's the easiest way to break a date with a guy?
Why don't you just do what we guys
do?
I want to guess what he says. Tell him dad has AIDS.
How does that work?
Just say something suddenly came up.
Something suddenly came up. That's all?
Yeah. It always works.
That's what dad says, then he points to the front of his jeans.
Yeah. Says not his T-cell count.
Hey, I'd like to come down and join you for brunch. Is that okay?
Go back. Go.
Oh, really?
Well, he played the whole clip so he could get his line in.
Yeah.
His one lousy line.
Oh?
It always works. I never would have said that to her.
Hey! Something suddenly came up. I never would have said that to her. What does he mean by that?
I don't know.
Like, so wouldn't he want something to suddenly come up? Like, you got a boner looking at her?
Yeah, you would think, right?
You would think.
That would be the joke.
I wouldn't say that to her.
That would be the joke.
I know what he meant. Yeah. The bile that comes up for the audience when they hear that line.
And eat this horrid food at the Yakov Smirnoff Theater.
Exactly. They're all having a fucking buttered roll where the butter's hard.
Some horrible roast beef.
A continental breakfast.
Too much fat on it. Ugh, the worst.
I hate the continental breakfast.
It fucking stinks.
Not breakfast. Don't try to cover it up with the word breakfast.
It's not. I'd rather eat the fucking TWA Flight 800 dinner.
Yeah, hear it.
All right. I'd like to come down and join you for brunch. Is that okay?
Pause when he shows the crowd.
Look at this crowd. The demo is like fucking
80 to 100.
And then there's a couple of younger people in there, but they're all these big, fat, like, Midwestern trash that couldn't quite make it to Vegas.
A lot of...
So they go to Branson.
A lot of women. A lot of unfuckable women.
They came there to see Greg Brady.
Yeah.
Come on.
So then he tries to brunch.
And then he talks to a woman. He talks to a woman about the brunch, I think. She's 90 years old.
Easily.
Oh, God. This is delicious.
There you go.
This is delicious.
I asked all of the
by
kids.
By that, she means her fucking trach tube. Fucking rotten old cunt. I hope she didn't make it out the front door.
Where are we?
Yeah.
Oh, we tried the brunch, so now it's back to some...
Try the wine.
Now it's back to some musical numbers.
Yeah.
Enjoying it. I asked all of the kids
stupid
give me their footage so that I could put it together and create home movies. I've set it to music, and it's a little glimpse of what we were like off the screen and off the set, just being the normal kids that we were.
Oh, God.
That's a montage of them.
And that's all films that were taken when they were, you know, you could find this set everywhere.
Oh, I know.
You didn't put it together.
No one put this together for him. It's been around forever.
Well, has it?
Oh, yeah.
I would say that was the only interesting thing, would just be to see them off camera.
Yeah, well, Mike Brady apparently, the dad there, gave them all, not AIDS, gave them all movie cameras.
Did
for, like, a gift.
I hit that.
You raise me up so I can stand on mountains.
It's going to finish strong.
You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. When I look back.
Is that what happened there? There's a little trickery.
I just want to know what the Yakov dinner adventure is about.
Yeah, I didn't.
Can we hear a little of this?
I'm going to watch this. This could be good, too.
It's like a commercial for it?
Mm-hmm.
What are people saying about Yakov's dinner adventure?
It was a great show. It's a beautiful show.
Yakov's dinner adventure is a must-see show.
Come see why audiences are raving about Yakov's dinner adventure.
We are travelers and we've been all over the shows too. New York, Vegas, London, and Paris. And this was probably one of the best.
Can you pause that by the way?
Yakov's show is one of the best.
No,
Paris, London, New York.
That was the worst.
You know what kind of shows we got here in New York, you stupid bitch?
But that was the worst sales job ever. Instead of saying this was the best, I loved it, she goes, this was probably one of the best. She couldn't
one
even
of.
Commit to it being the best.
You're right.
And she's petting her daughter's hair because she knows what she's saying is just a filled
she's
with lies.
She's pulling the kid's hair like, don't fucking say it.
Yeah,
don't say you enjoyed Wicked, you motherfucker.
Mama, you said this torrible.
She was afraid the kid was going to...
Mama, you say piece of shit. Yeah. Mama, you say Russian thief.
Eating that horrible food. They showed a picture of it. It looked awful.
Can we see the food?
Look at this.
That's a nice dinner choice.
Oh, stop.
A little parfait for dessert.
Isn't that awful?
Oh, blackaroo.
What is that? Look at that muffin. What is that thing? A corn muffin?
I don't know.
What is the mashed potatoes they slop out of a big vat? What's the gray shit? What is that?
It's supposed
to be
meat. It's the meat that fucking chef tried to cook before he went into the military. It was gray.
It was gray.
All marbled.
And then there's some chicken, like broiled chicken.
Why do you need chicken if you got the meat?
It looks like the soles of shoes.
And look at that horrible muffin.
Oof. Yeah, that little thing looks like a cockhead.
What is that glowing thing? An egg next to it? What
it's
is
like
that?
It's a candle.
A little candle
at dinner. They bring the candle on your fucking tray.
It's on the plate next to the napkin. That's a fire hazard.
Let's see. There's a...
Soleil in Las Vegas, and this was better.
Join us for a magnificent show.
I'm sorry, we're going to have to stop this a bunch.
She might be telling the truth. Cirque was okay.
I've seen three of their shows. They're fucking amazing.
You loved them?
I can't imagine.
Amazing.
I saw one in Disney, and I saw one in I forgot where else. Oh, the Bahamas somewhere down there.
I didn't like the water one as much, but it was still amazing.
But you cannot fucking tell me that the one in Branson, Missouri, during Yakov Smirnoff's fucking dinner adventure, is going to be better than the one in Vegas.
They're probably swinging minorities from the ceiling. That's why they all love it.
But stupid Yakov is making it sound like you see all this during his show. I think this is just a general thing of what you see.
Oh, I think this is Yakov's dinner adventure, sir. I think it is all exclusive to Yakov's dinner adventure.
Wow. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. All right.
It's under the banner of Yakov's Dinner Adventure.
All right, a lot of big acts.
Let's
is probably one of the best. I paid more to see Cirque du Soleil in Las Vegas, and this was better.
Join us for a magnificent show experience and a mouth-watering, fun-filled dinner.
Ew.
All right, could you go back to the mouth-watering, fun-filled dinner? I want to see.
Horrible. What, right, oh no, they get this. They get participate. They get the people participating.
It's the same food, but he just rotated.
He rotated the platter a little bit. But that looks awful.
Could he put the muffin in the middle?
Could he, by the way, have put it on a worse tablecloth?
Yeah,
it's what like the fuck is that?
It looks like oldie estate type wallpaper.
Mm-hmm. It looks like the fucking rug Nicholson was dancing on when he got a little bit of avocado spilled on his jacket.
It's the ballroom fucking carpet.
With the overlook.
Look at the tiny tray.
And then you know what?
It makes me uncomfortable.
They probably got to show, by law, they have to show what you're going to get.
Yeah.
They give you water with a slice of lemon.
Yeah, well.
No know. Beverage.
Well, that's where they make their money.
On beverages?
I would bet money.
It's $40 a clip for this fucking thing.
I would bet money, though. No fucking wine or beer.
No.
That's separate.
Beer is $300 a glass.
Oh, I don't doubt it. What a country.
What a country. He's right.
Well, let's see what happens with the, because I think I saw some audience participation, which is the best part of any show. All right, let her rip. Let me see.
Fun-filled dinner that you and your family will never forget.
We love the patriotism.
I want us. Go to... America!
All the shows we've seen, this was one of the best. Well, we came back a second time.
It's a new breath of fresh air in here. I think it's wonderful. I think the Moscow Circus gave us a chance to laugh, participate with audience participation with the balls and the balloon, and brought a tear to my eye at the conclusion. It just had so much truth to it. It was wonderful.
Boy. What an incredible story.
Pause right there.
All right.
They're doing it in front of a Statue of Liberty.
Yes, with an American flag. And this is so douchey. Imagine having to sit through this shit.
These fucking boobs all think it's patriotic.
Yeah, this forced patriotism.
A breath of fresh air. There's no fucking way.
Ugh.
It's just a bunch of 85-year-olds just farting.
Yeah, fresh air, farting out that bad meat farts.
Can you imagine
Yakov's platter?
Horrendous the farts are in that place.
Oh, God. Let's see what else happens.
This is what we have to look forward to when we get older, right?
Yeah.
This shit. This is what's going to happen.
Oh, my God, it's the Osmond brothers.
But you got to think that there was a time they were young doing their thing, and now this is what we have to look forward to when we get older, right?
Yep.
Fuck.
Yeah. The whole story was an emotional thing for me. I mean, I just got literally tears in my eyes. I was expecting good Russian dancing, as it was wonderful, but what I wasn't expecting.
Pauses, please.
Oh, boy. The Osmonds.
That man's head is being attacked by a carpeting.
Now, there are three of the Osmond brothers there. Two of them are completely white hair.
Well, they've decided to let time do its thing. And the one looks exactly like Donny Osmond as an old guy.
Yeah.
That's creepy.
There's one on the left, though, that refuses. He's wearing the worst wig ever.
It's terrible.
Ever.
With the darkest color. I don't even think Just for Men makes that color.
No,
where
no.
Where the fuck did he get that color?
That is a wig on his head.
The famous soy sauce, I guess.
Yeah, soy sauce.
He's got a goatee that is fucking dark.
Yeah.
That color is black squared. What a fucking horrendous rug that is.
Horrid. He's got to be at least 65.
Yeah.
What is he doing? His brothers are doing it right. Just letting time do its toll.
I got a tear in my eye.
In my eye, I guess.
I realize how much I paid for this garbage.
I can't help it.
But what I wasn't expecting, that it just blew my mind away, it was just the effects. The fire, the bubbles. The unicycle.
Already pause right there.
There's a big drop off.
Did he just say the effects? The grown man said the fire and the bubbles.
They couldn't.
The effects
they were
they
the
showed
smallest bubbles ever.
Was a little flame of like flash paper on the stage. And then somebody blowing bubbles out of a fucking big hoop on the stage. Those are effects.
No, it wasn't a big hoop.
It was a little hoop.
Make sure you pause when the bubbles pop up.
But what an idiot to say and the bubble. Who says and the bubbles?
That was the second thing that came to mind with the effects. Right. Fire and then the bubbles.
Well, they should be saying that when these three are taking a bath. What's coming up from his fucking mouth and nose?
As the water's turning black from his wig.
The effects. The fire, the bubbles.
That's tiny bubbles.
That's the worst.
Jesus, what is wrong with these people?
Who is going to this?
But who would edit this and go, yeah, we're talking about the big special effects, and then they leave the little bubbles in.
The bubbles.
It's a guy just with a regular bubble thing that he just blew.
The bendy pencil.
Right.
When he has the pencil between his fingers, I thought it was a rubber pencil. That's please, I need more.
Yakov. The unicycle. Already unicycle.
And what was that thing that was going?
The human slinky.
Unbelievable.
My favorite part was the human slinky.
Our favorite part was the slinky.
Yay.
Yeah, the human slinky was just amazing.
What's
I'm
amazing?
I'm passionate about this show. I love what they do.
It looks like a prolapsed asshole.
Right, let's look at their dumb fucking human slinky that everyone's fucking creaming over.
About the show. I love what I do, and when we created this show, we want to touch all five senses. And when I say five senses, I mean smell and taste too.
Ah, that's
the farce. Because when we
now
they're showing the horrible dinner again as part of the smell and taste.
And they decide not to rotate the dinner this time around.
No.
The same shot from the second shot of the dinner plate.
What is that little white cup thing with green stuff?
It's cum.
Yeah, it looks like a semen
like
sample.
Bukkake.
It's dumb. It's soup. It's that, I think it's that broccoli cream soup.
You turn to your neighbor and heave it on their back.
Do you think that's, that is a tiny tray,
it's
though.
It's the smallest cup of soup ever.
It really is. Look at the silverware. You could tell how small everything is.
Get a thimble of soup.
$40, you're getting that and that wonderful entertainment.
With the horrible vegetable medley.
Wow.
Nothing worse than a vegetable medley.
I hate fucking vegetable medleys.
They're the worst.
There's nothing medley about it.
Some tells me they're opening a lot of cellophane bags in the kitchen down there in Branson. A lot of fucking plastic bags are being opened.
And that horrible gray meat again.
Yeah, the gray meat.
Stop showing the horrible dinner and trying to make believe it's fun. Didn't they call it fun?
I would just eat the mashed
potatoes. Fun-filled
dinner. This is the longest commercial for Yakov's dinner adventure.
Well, this was supposed to be about Greg Brady, but we found another nugget of gold
here. Oh, yeah. Anything in Branson.
The Yakov dinner adventure. Go ahead.
Our dinner, not only our performers will be dancing, but your taste buds will, too.
Ah, your taste buds will be dancing, too, not just the performers.
Looks like he hires a lot of Russians, huh?
Yeah. He brought them all over.
The Russians employed.
Former KGB.
Mm-hmm.
Will, too.
The food was wonderful and very much worth the price.
The food was fun.
I cleaned my plate.
It was much better than I expected, and it was nice and hot. I don't know how you did it, but it was great.
Hold on, pause that.
What?
This woman is awed by the fact that the food was hot. Where do you live, you cunt, in an igloo?
She's not expecting much. She didn't set her sights high, so she wouldn't be disappointed.
What'd you expect, donkey shit on a plate?
But once again, a guy did all the interviews, and he put this together. Yeah, Why would you leave the part where she's amazed that the food was
hot? I don't
know
how you did it. An oven?
Yeah.
You dummy.
How boring is your place that you're leaving that clip in?
Not many of the brothers down there in the shows at Branson. I see a common theme. White people.
Old white people.
She looks like a fucking grown-up Oliver from the Brady Bunch. What an ugly woman.
Yeah, she really is.
Let's 2 weeks. I hate this lady.
She just showed her amazement that they keep the food hot.
Yeah, rewind. Let me hear her say she's amazed by the hot food.
This is the promo video, and they had to leave this in for some reason. I don't get it. I don't get it, but hit it.
I claimed my play. It was much better than I expected, and it was nice and hot. I don't know how you did it, but it was great.
This is a fantastic meal prepared for you by my person.
He's showing the stupid plate of food again.
Yakov's got the platter in his hand. He's wearing the Russian customary wool hat, like he's ready to do that dumb Russian dance. And he's wearing like the Russian tea room waiter outfits.
Yeah.
And now he's going to tell us about the food himself.
Why? The food looks shitty.
Oh, he's talking this shit up, dude. All right, you got to sell it.
All right, let's go.
It looks shitty, so Yakov's got to talk it up.
He's got the tray of food in his left hand, and he's using his right hand, gesturing a lot.
Yes.
Here we go.
Fantastic meal prepared for you by my personal chef. You get beef brisket, a chicken breast fillet, creamy mashed potatoes, vegetable medley, a sweet corn muffin, and a delicious soup. This mouth-watering meal served to you on the golden platter with linen napkins, real silverware, and a fake candle.
Wow. I am so sick of hearing real silverware.
He's selling the real silverware
part of it.
And why is his nose clogged?
And these plates don't have holes in middle, so food will not tumble to floor when plates picked up. Gives a shit.
He's selling like the worst thing. An actual bowl to hold your soup. You don't have to have it ladled hot into your cupped hands.
Other with linen napkins, real silverware, and a fake candle. And to top it all off.
Oh, he's laughing.
I would bet a lot of money that he might have ate the food once.
Oh, you don't eat that shit.
To put his stamp of approval on it.
Hasn't eaten
it since.
They need a fake candle because the Yakov had a dream that he's standing outside his place up in flames with just on fire old people running out of the place.
Calling lawyers.
Horrific pain. What the country.
Well, I'm sure there's a lot of people in there with oxygen tanks and stuff.
Yeah, probably. You can't have any open flames around the
table.
Extremely
dry blue hair. I mean, you can't have fucking candles around that joint.
Some old broad's head fucking catches on fire. How great would that be? All that hairspray they put in.
He does sound stuffy.
He sounds extremely stuffy.
What the country.
He's very stuffy.
He's got a weird color in his beard, too, man.
Yeah, something's going on there. Looks like he painted it on.
Yeah, very, very strange. Hit it.
All right. Now it's dessert.
And to top it all off, scrumptious strawberry Romanov, which is a Russian version of strawberry shortcake. We take our food from...
You notice how he made believe he was going in for a scoop, and then they cut it?
Yeah.
Because Yakov don't eat that shit.
Yakov ain't eating that shit.
He don't eat that shit.
He goes back to his fucking room, and there's just chicks, naked chicks, and cocaine.
When he takes a bite, he probably spit it out. He goes, "This tastes like cock of moose."
Remember, it's his own private chef.
My own private chef.
You think his own private chef is sitting there fucking slopping this shit out for the old people?
No.
Hell no.
We take our food preparation very seriously. Everything from the corn muffins to the brisket is prepared right here in our very own kitchen.
Well, where else would it
My
be prepared?
Personal chef and his team can make up to 1,800 meals in a single show.
Some people ask, How can you eat dinner in the theater?
No one asked.
There's no table.
Because there's no entertainment to distract you. So while you're watching people jump like fools, you can eat without worrying to applause or laugh.
Okay. I just heard something.
I heard it too.
This could be great. See, I thought I got to give it away ahead of time. I was very extremely uncomfortable by the tray.
The tray,
because everything is squeezed onto the tray. You feel like you're in a hoarder's house.
Oh,
there's
no
room for anything. Now this
rewind her and let her say what she just said.
How could you eat dinner without a table?
Listen to this.
Single show.
Some people ask, how can you eat dinner in the theater since there's no table?
Oh, no.
You have to put shitty tray on your lap.
Precariously balance that fucking thing on your lap.
It's the tiniest tray ever.
That's what the fucking... Oh, what are these little fold-out things?
No. Oh. I'm sure you just rested on your fucking... Well, she'll probably explain.
She's going to explain, but you... Oh, my God.
Oh,
people are
man.
Spilling food left and right.
You know
right.
why? Because then they could just come in and sweep the floor down and get another show going. They don't have to clean tables. They don't have to worry about tables and chairs.
Nothing worse than when you have to eat your meal on your lap.
Well, what do they do? But what do they sit on? Are they just chairs?
We're going to find out. What do you think?
Fists.
I don't know, but this sounds like so fucking bad. $40, no table?
She's going to brag about the tiny tray, I think.
Yeah, that's definitely it. All right, let's hear.
Come on, I'll show you.
Okay, show us.
Oh, it's like
actually, we do have tables.
No, you don't.
And they're custom built just for our
dinner. They flip out like an airplane.
We have a little secret. There are four very strong magnets embedded in each table. It prevents sliding and slipping.
The only way to really
pause, why are they promoting the stupid fucking tray table?
With the magnets.
So you got to sit there in a theater seat, like a movie theater seat that has a fold-out thing like an airplane, like in the armrest. It comes out and then sit there and eat literally 2 inches away from the slob next to you.
Do you know how many fucking people must
promoting it this way? Yeah, this is the final selling point where you're like, oh, the four magnets. We got to get tickets immediately.
Four magnets?
I didn't know they had the four
magnets.
I
thought there were three. I was expecting three magnets. I'm very impressed with Yakov's theater.
This place gives you four.
Four magnets.
Honey, we got to get tickets for the next show.
We've been to so many two-magnet places, and the tray slipped and slid all night.
Do you know how many old people must be cutting the meat and the tray flips on the floor?
Yes.
So they finally had to come up with the magnet system.
But you're just hitting elbows with some geriatric fucking disgusting slob.
Oh, man. Fucking getting old's gonna suck.
Yakov. Fuck. You think Yakov sits down there in those chairs and eats on his fucking four magnet tray?
No, he's having his sinuses fixed.
Oh, God.
But half the videos, this lady fucking promoting the magnets.
I'd love to see the fucking magnets pull an old bag's bridge work right out of her mouth. Bang! It just fucking flies out of her face onto the tray.
They're just addressing what they know the old people watching this are going to be asking.
Exactly. Yeah, I'm sure.
By accident.
Absolutely.
Let's learn about the magnets, please. I need to know more about the magnets. Yeah.
The only way to really say it in words is that it's an experience. I don't think it's a show. I think it's beyond that. There's an emotional value in this show that it's hard to put in words, and I think you just have to see it to really understand it.
Yakov's Dinner Adventure. It will blow you away.
Oh, man. That looked like a goof.